Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to play DVD content in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've maybe played DVD content in previous versions of ProPresenter and you're trying to figure out why you can't do it in Pro 7, go ahead, like, subscribe, and share this, just so that other people know how to do this. So, a while back, I did a kind of roundup of the stuff that ProPresenter 6 could do that ProPresenter 7 can do. Could not do, rather. And so, this is one of those things. But I don't think I told you how to get around that problem. So, I thought that we would dive into this and try and figure out just how would you go about playing DVD content in ProPresenter 7. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So here we are in Pro 7, and if we go to screens, it's not there. If we go to view, I mean, we could look through all this, but there's no DVD thing here. And the reason for that is DVDs are kind of outdated. Even Blu-rays are kind of outdated. In fact, as it turns out, I haven't bought a new computer with a optical drive in a while. In fact, my daughter just bought, you know, this is a Mac, so you might expect that. Well, my daughter, my youngest, just bought a gaming computer, and it also doesn't have an optical drive. So that's the first piece of the puzzle is, do you even have a computer that has an optical drive to play a DVD or a Blu-ray? Because if you don't, nothing else I'm about to tell you is going to help, because you can't, like, just hold up the disc at the camera of the computer and have it read it. It just doesn't work like that. So that's thing number one, and that's the first obstacle that a lot of people need to consider before they move past that. Second thing, even if you did get a drive, a lot of the, well, I think both operating systems, both Windows and Mac OS, at least recent versions of them, don't come with the Blu-ray or DVD playing software. So that's a bit of a challenge too, because the reason for this is actually pretty straightforward. MPEG 2 costs money. And why would the operating system include software in it that costs them money when likely you don't have the hardware to support it? So that's thing number two. These are a couple of the reasons why I don't think Renewed Vision is ever going to ship a, oh, we're going to play DVDs or Blu-rays with this version of ProPresenter. I just don't see it happening. But that doesn't help you, not even a little bit. So let me talk about something that may help you, and then we'll go from there. So going back to the computer, not in ProPresenter, but if we go to, I've just got Firefox here. You could get there from Chrome, Safari, basically any of the web browsers. Go to handbrake, like from a bicycle, the brake that you apply using your hand. Handbrake, spelled the same way. handbrake.fr. Why is it not .com? Don't know. Why .fr, which is the French extension when it's clearly in English? Also don't know. But handbrake.fr is where you can download this free software. Now, I'm on a Mac, so of course it says, hey, download this for Mac OS. But if you click down here, I can also download it for Windows or even Linux. But all that to say, these are the basic versions that you're going to download. So I have already done that, and let me drag this over here, and this is the Handbrake software. I've just updated it, so I'm not totally sure that this would work or not, because like I said, I just updated it. But what I would do is I would click on open source up here and navigate to where the disk is. Now, it's also important that you know a couple of things about copyright. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. So, first off, if you're trying to play a movie like, I don't know, Dune Part 2, or I just saw Inside Out Part 2, if you're watching a Hollywood movie, chances are it's technically illegal for you to rip that. So do keep that in mind. That's thing number one. And by the way, it doesn't matter if you can rip it or not. It's probably illegal for you to do so. So do keep that in mind. Thing number two, it could be that the disc that you have is not a DVD movie disc. It's not one that you could just take and put into any Blu-ray player or DVD player. It could be that it's just a disc with files on it. And if that's the case, then you don't even need Handbrake. You can use just your regular software, open that up, drag it to your storage drive, probably your SSD, and just play it from there. You're going to want an MP3. File or an MOV file. Maybe on Windows you might get away with an AVI file, but those are probably where I would start. Now, it could be that it still doesn't play. If you've got one of those file types, then do bring it into Handbrake and you can transcode it into something more viewable, because it could be that it's a file from Vacation Bible School or something, and they've chosen, for whatever reasons, a kind of odd codec. So a codec is kind of an instruction set that's on the back end. It's not immediately obvious what codec you're using, and you would need to bring it into something to change it from, for example, ProRes 4444. Which they might have chosen because it includes transparency. Well, if you don't need transparency, then maybe you just need to change it into a good old H.264 or H.265 file. Again, with the file extension .mp4, .mov, or .avi if you're on Windows, perhaps. So just keep all of that in mind, that it's not as simple as maybe it seems just at first blush. You're not going to put it into an optical drive of your computer and play it just like it's playing from a DVD drive or from a DVD player that's a standalone device that plugs into a TV or a Blu-ray player, whatever. Because it may not be that type of disc, and even if it is that type of disc, it might have copy protection that kind of keeps you from doing it. And it's probably okay that it does, because it's technically illegal to do that, and illegal to show it in a group context. One way around that, by the way, is you can get a license to show it in a group context, but the actual practical nature of showing it may be problematic. So that's kind of the downside of trying to play DVD content in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.